My inventions will change the world. I'll finish the perpetual fission reactor if it's the last thing I do.
Zip, please.
I don't care what it costs.
Chapter 6, The Price of Power.
Greetings.
I'll be counting on you.
Oi!
Blimey!
Well, now.
Forgive me. Of course. Now, hey. Well,
Hey there!
Thank you! Huh?
Say.
Oh, come on!
Thank you.
Eat this!
Wow. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, and?
Listen. Oh! Golly.
Hey!
Look!
What is that thing? It appears to be an airship of some sort.
Look at the face on it!
We're ready when you are, Bracken. Just say the word.
Thanks, Trey. Maybe now you'll listen, Zip.
For too long, the President has been working us like slaves to get his perpetual fission reactor finished. But we have a message for him. We are not your slaves, Zip.
We're not slaves! We're not slaves!
We demand workers' rights. We demand fair treatment. We've had it with being worked half to death. No more reactor. No more overtime.
We're not slaves! We're not slaves!
Sounds like I'm gonna have to let some people go. Happens to those who defy me!
Finally decided to make an appearance, huh, Mr. President?
What a disappointment to see you leading this ragtag resistance. You know, I expected better of you, Bracken.
I expected better of you, too. Have you forgotten what we said when we started out? We promised to make the world a better place, remember?
And we will! The perpetual fission reactor will change the world forever! And the future will be mine to define!
Even if it means trampling over everybody who helped you make it this far? You used to care about us. You used to be a leader people could trust. But that's all gone. Now it's progress or nothing, no matter the cost. When did you get so broken?
Ha! I'm the broken one? Look at yourselves, stuck in the past, left behind by the march of progress. I don't need you anymore.
It is time.
Do you really think you can stop me? Well, let me tell you something, friend. Anybody who stands in my way... gets atomized!
Hey. Yes. Holy. Thank you. Huh?
Now... If I may be so bold...
Excuse me?
Huh.
Hey, Bracken, there's something up with this circuit. Can you take a look?
Sure, let me see. Yeah, I think you're getting some leakage right about here. Okay, leave it with me and I'll see what I can do.
Oh, that'd be great, thanks. I can't wait to get the crystal battery up and running. This thing's gonna be a game changer for the energy business. The technology we build here today will make a better tomorrow for everybody. I can feel it.
Me too. Wow.
Yeah!
Huh.
You're right. Thanks.
What the?
Oh no.
Right. Alrighty. Thank you. Alrighty.
Zip, the launch was a disaster. Everybody hates it. Half the units we shipped have been returned. What?
Why?
Why?
Damn it, my design was perfect!
I'm sorry, Zip. This is the end for us, huh? We're finished. Man. Oh, man. What are we gonna do?
You're gonna quit whining and start thinking, that's what. This isn't the end, it's the beginning. Someday soon, the world will finally understand my vision. We're not giving up until that day comes.
We nearly went under, right then and there. I can remember sitting up crying all night long. It was hard. But nobody did more to get us back on our feet than Zip. He was an inspiration.
God, dang it! Sorry. Shut up! Shut up, shut up, shut up!
Yeah.
Gah.
Alrighty. Alrighty.
Now, thank you.
Thank you.
Uh-huh.
It's finally ready! Behold, the all-singing, all-dancing Smart Stick! With one of these revolutionary devices, anyone can be a wizard. No more magic monopoly for the casting classes. Now, there'll be spells for everybody!
You did it, Zip. Congratulations!
Hey, hey, I couldn't have done it without you guys. This was a team effort. Don't forget that. I know I won't. Thank you, all of you.
We were a team back then. We all thought the same way, wanted the same thing. How did it all go so wrong?
Well, you see...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Alrighty.
Hmm.
Listen. Oh.
Thank you.
Alrighty.
Okay, listen, everybody. We've brought a string of hit products to market that have changed the world forever. And thanks to all of your hard work, now we've built this to our revolutionary new campus, the Treehouse. And that's not all the good news. We just added our 315,639th team member, which means we're not a company anymore. We're a nation in our own right. Soon, we'll be the biggest and best this world has ever seen. Just one last push. Are you with me?
Woo, yeah! We're with you, Zip!
Vector! Vector! Vector!
What a day. A company that started out in a shack got big enough to build this place. Got so big that it became an actual country. He had a vision for the Treehouse. He wanted to build a place where people could live happy and work happy. And dang it if he didn't do just that. I had my doubts, you know. He was a different person back then. He had a smile for everybody. Where did the old Zip go?
Well, you see...
Mm-hmm.
Golly. Come on.
Watch your back! Here goes!
Gah! Can't wait to get the crystal battery up and running. This thing's gonna be a game changer for the energy business. The technology we build here today will make a better tomorrow for everybody. I can feel it. Someday soon, the world will finally understand my vision. We're not giving up until that day comes. Hey, hey, I couldn't have done it without you guys. This was a team effort. Don't forget that. I know I will. Soon, we'll be the biggest and best this world has ever seen. Just one last push. Are you with me? Why was I?
There's one last memory I want to show you. Please. You have to remember who you used to be. You have to bring the old Zip back.
So I stayed up all night making this for you? How about that, huh? A custom leg made just for you by the world's greatest engineer. You're gonna love it.
This isn't my leg. I want my leg. I want my...
No, I get it, Bracken. I get that you're upset, but... We're engineers. We solve humanity's problems. We use technology to help people. That's our purpose. That's what we do. Now, do you really want a little thing like this to stop you from fulfilling that purpose? We solve humanity's problems, and we solve each other's too, right? You lose a leg, I make you a new one. I lose a hand, well, you know, I hope you do the same for me.
Oh, Zip.
And this leg, it's not just a machine. I put my heart and soul into it. It's a part of me.
Thank you.
Hey, I'm your boss. It's my job.
Look, Zip, look at it! You've seen the things we can do these days. I could have upgraded it. I could have gotten rid of the leg you made me. But I would never do that. This leg is what gave me the courage to carry on. What got me where I am today? You were the best engineer, the best boss, the best friend anyone could have. You had a good heart. The best. You have to remember. You have to.
I remember now. I remember everything. What have I done?
Zip, it's you, isn't it? The real you. You're back.
Bracken, I'm so sorry. If it wasn't for you, I don't think I ever would have remembered.
Everything's shaking!
Oh no! Bastion!
Well. Aha! Attention all team members! I need you to channel all available power into the reactor's high-pressure inlets right now!
But President Vector, they weren't designed to take that kind of punishment. And you know what that means better than anybody.
The reactor will go critical and the core will fuse. In other words, we'll wind up with the world's most expensive hunk of junk. Are you sure about this, Zip? She's your baby.
It's that, or risk the lives of every person in this country. You think I'd hesitate for even one second? I'm the executive director of this company and the leader of this nation. Nothing is more important than my people. So flood the damn tubes! That's an order!
Yes, sir. For Broadleaf.
Oh my goodness!
okay. Ha!
He's got to be around here somewhere. Oh.
Not so fast.
Here goes!
Evan!
I understand now! A leader must be willing to give his life to protect his people. That's what Zip is planning to do. But I'm not going to let him. Not now. I won't run away. Not again. Not ever!
Oh, Evan? Oh, flipping Eggman, I am buzzing. Here goes nothing.
Yeah.
you're kidding! And there I was, just getting used to being big and long and handsome again. Knickers!
Exactly.
What? Go on, my son.
But I...
Don't deserve to run this country, huh? I think the people might have something to say about that.
President Vector, I came here originally to ask you something. You see, I'm trying to bring peace to our world. Real, lasting peace. But I will need your help to do it. Can I count on your support?
Oh, I'm sure we can come to some kind of an arrangement. We'd need a preferential trade agreement, of course. Do you guys have an official technology partner?
For the sake of the world.
Let the banners of war ne'er again be unfurled.
United we stand as one single land.
So he's looking to bring back this Horned One, and you're looking to stop him?
Yes. And if we can join forces with the other kingdoms, we may just stand a chance.
I see. And out of the big players, there's only Ding Dong Dell left now, huh? That could be difficult.
Yes.
But I can tell by your face, you're not gonna back down. Luckily, we'll be right behind you. You have my word as president of Broadleaf.
Thank you so much.
You'll be going with our new friends, Bracken?
Yes, Mr. President. Just as you ordered.
But is that really all right? Bracken's awfully important to your kingdom, isn't she?
Sure, and she'll be important to yours too. I could hardly send some second-tier engineer to help our new partners now, could I?
You heard the man. I'll be on hand for all your mechanical and technological needs from now on. From hair clips to airships, I'm your gal.
So President Vector was freed from the grip of his obsession. and Broadleaf became the next country to sign up to the Declaration of Interdependence. And not only that, but Evan found a new friend in Bracken Meadows, whose endless inventiveness was sure to help Evermore flourish as never before. Only one great nation now remained. Ding Dong Dell.
So Lottie finally showed his true power.
Yes, it was such a surprise. You never would have guessed from looking at him.
And everything seems to be settling down in Broadleaf too.
It does, yes. President Vector is back to his old self. I'm sure he'll put his people first from now on. And his friends will learn to trust him again soon enough. The bond between them is too strong for them to hold a grudge. I only hope that I can forge such firm friendships. I've a long way to go before people look up to me like they do Zip, though. I'm nothing like him.
It takes all kinds of kings to make a world. I think you should just keep doing what you're doing.
Perhaps you're right.
Hey, Evan. Have you ever thought about what you'd do if someone really close to you betrayed you?
What?
Oh, I was just wondering. Forget I asked.